again, just relaxing in your chair. Happy Wednesday. Thanks again for joining me. Just use your breath here as you just take a moment just to settle everything down. Just really connect with your breath. So this week, we are talking about spring cleaning. I'd like to call it spring cleaning. And maybe you've already done your spring cleaning. I don't know, we're still in spring. We're kind of in the latter part of spring, but we're still in spring. Maybe you've already done some, or maybe you're getting ready to do some, but spring cleaning is a wonderful thing to do in our homes, but also just in our lives. Just getting rid of the clutter, getting rid of the mess, eliminating things that distract us. And we know that God has some great verses in the book of John about this. It's about the vine and the branches. And he talks about cutting back and how important that is. So in John 15, 1 through 3, it says, "I am the true vine, and my Father is the gardener. He cuts off every branch in me that bears no fruit, while every branch that does bear fruit, he prunes so that it will be even more fruitful. You are already clean because of this word that I have spoken to you." So cutting back and pruning makes us stronger. It makes us more capable, just like those vines, those branches that are stronger, that produce more fruit. We're better off when we cut back. And today we're just talking about more from a physical sense. On Thursday, we'll talk more from a spiritual sense. But today, just thinking about how you can simplify, how you can clear out things that do not serve you, things that do not help you, how you can get rid of things that drag you down in your life. And it might be physical things. Sometimes, unfortunately, it's relationships. It might be bad habits. Things that weigh us down. Things that drag us down. Let's take a moment here just to breathe and just think about these things we might need to eliminate in our lives. Sit really tall. So coming towards that edge of your chair, sit really tall, those feet on the ground, big breath up, inhaling, stretching all the way up, drawing your hands together in prayer. Exhale as you bring those hands down to where your heart is. And we'll do it again. Big breath up, inhale, stretching all the way up towards the sky, hands together in prayer. Drop it down with your exhale. And we'll do it one more time. Big breath up. Stretching up, really feel that body lengthening up towards the sky, hands together in prayer, drop it down. We're going to stay right here and just really press your palms together. I want you to feel the strength in your hands and your palms and your arms and your upper body. So really press that together. Make sure all your fingers are lined up. So all your fingers and your thumbs are lined up. Press those in. We'll take a big breath in. And a big breath out. Really press those palms together. Feel your knuckles pressing into each other. All right, nice job. Gently release. Float your arms down to your sides. Bring your left leg up. Bend your knee. Interlace your fingers either at your lower leg or behind your knee and draw that leg in. So bring it into your body. And then we're going to circle your foot. Okay, so if you have shoes on, like I do, you can still spread out your toes. Think about your toes and your shoes, or maybe you want to take your shoes off. It's always nice to have slip-ons for this class, so you can slip them on and off. But really spread out your toes, and we'll reverse the foot. You're working into your foot, your ankle, your toes. Keep drawing that leg in. Nice job. We'll take one more. And we'll gently release, drop that leg back down to the ground. We'll do the other side, bring that leg up. And again, holding behind the knee or your shin, draw that leg in and then circle the foot. Okay, focusing on your ankle, your foot, your toes. Yeah, if you can wear slip-ons for the class, you guys, it's an awesome option to be able to get in and out of them when you need to. Let's go ahead and reverse. And make sure you're not slouching. Number one rule, don't slouch. Keep that spine tall. Great job. We'll take one more. Really nice. Go ahead and drop it down. So bring your cactus arms up. And we're going to lean back. So I'm going to turn sideways for you. So leaning back, lifting up your gaze, your chin, lifting that chest. Breathing into the chest. I'm going to take 5 breaths. Deep breaths into your chest. Two more. Feel that really nice back bend here. All right, and then just drop your hands to your chair. Okay, so you're leaning back even more, taking that back bend, lifting your heart space. I'll turn sideways for you guys, really leaning back. Okay, feel that nice expansion into your chest. Feel your shoulder blades coming together in the back. And we'll just take a couple breaths here. If this bothers your neck at all, feel free to bring your chin towards your chest. Okay, one more breath. Bring it back into center. Way to go. All right, so interlace your fingers, draw it up to your chest, and then press your palms out. So drop your chin here, round your spine as you look down. And then bring your arms up overhead as you press your palms towards the sky, sitting really tall. And then we're going to stretch to the side. So stretching out the side of your body, you can look up under your top arm if that feels good for your neck. We'll come back into center and we'll go the other way. Stretching out the side of the body, looking up under your top arm if you want to. Bring it back into center. We're going to float those arms down. So now let's really incorporate the breath. So we're going to inhale as we bring the hands up to the chest. Fingers are interlaced. We're going to exhale, round the back, drop the chin, press the palms away from you. We're going to inhale and take it up overhead. Press those palms up towards the sky. Nice long stretch. And then we're going to exhale to the side, getting that side body stretch. And we're going to inhale to center. We're going to exhale the other way. Inhale back to center. Exhale and float your arms down. So we're going to do that again. So with every movement, there's a breath. Inhale up, exhale out, round your back. Draw your belly button towards your spine. Inhale up, lengthening all the way up, palms pressing up towards the sky. Exhale, stretch out the side of the body. Inhale, bring it back into center, and exhale to the other side. Inhale, bring it back into center, and exhale, float your arms down. This is our last time. So again, breath with movement. Every movement has a breath. Inhale up, exhale round, press the palms out, drop your chin. Inhale up, press those palms towards the sky. Exhale to the side. Stretch out the side of the body. Inhale, center, Exhale the other way. Inhale to center. And exhale and float your arms down. Great job, you guys. Shake out your hands. Shake out those arms. Super job. Bring your hands to your legs. We're going to take some nice big circles with our core. So go wherever you want to go with this. Make it as big as you want. Just move really slowly. And see what you feel. And maybe you want to close your eyes. Just really notice your core. Warming that core up. We're working our core today as we usually do, some days more than others. One more circle here, and then we'll gently reverse. Again, just moving into that upper body, using your breath. So, again, we want to use our breath as we move. Nice job. Let's take one more. And we'll bring it back into center. Sit really tall. Bring your arms up, shoulder level. We're going to cross one hand over the other and then take it really wide all the way out. And then we'll go the other way. Opposite hand on top. Take it all the way out. And then just keep switching as you cross and all the way out. Keep switching. As you take the arms out, think about drawing your shoulder blades together in the back and give a little squeeze into your shoulder blades. And strengthening your shoulders and your upper back. Okay, so make sure you're sitting tall. You're breathing. Breath with movement. Just take three more. There's three and two and last one. Good job, you guys. Bring your hands to your shoulders. Drop your shoulders down and then just circle out your neck. Just really nice and easy here. Nice big slow circles. Again, maybe closing your eyes. Just take your time. Working out the kinks in your neck. And then we'll go the other way. So when you're ready, slow it down, reverse. Always breathing. Oh, Julie did join us. Welcome, Julie. Welcome, welcome. All right, let's take one or two more here. And bring it back into center. Great job, you guys. All right, let's get that heart going. So we're going to tap it out to the side. So we're going to take a leg out and tap it out to each side. And then incorporating your arms when you're ready, we're going to lift those elbows. So arms are bent. You're going to lift those elbows, those little chicken wings, working into your shoulders and your deltoids, those muscles on the outsides of your arms, strengthening those. So make sure you're sitting tall. Nice strong core here. Starting to get that heart rate going. So you can stay here, or your option is to grab your water bottles or your weights or your cans, and you can use those as well here to strengthen those arms. Nice job, you guys. Way to go. Let's go five more here, four more, three more, two more, and one more. So keep your legs moving out to the side, but now punch in front. Okay, it can be set, same leg and same arm or opposite, doesn't matter. Just keep tapping out to the side and punch in front. And you can use your weights or not. If you want to drop the weights, you can drop them. Make it your own. Make sure it works for you. Great job, you guys. Let's go five more, four more, three more, two more, and last one. So now we're going to take it out to the side. So as you tap out, press those arms out. And again, with your weights or Not with your weights. Okay, palms are facing forward. Make it really strong, really press it out. And if you're not using your weights, press the palms of your hands out and the heels of your hands out. Okay, let's do five more, whichever way you want to do them. Four more, three more, sitting nice and tall, two more, and one more. Good job. Go ahead and drop your weights down just for a bit. We're going to come down at 45 degrees, so bring your body down, and we're going to go back to that movement that we were doing before, lifting those elbows with the arms bent. Okay, so you're looking at the ground, maybe your feet. Feel that core, that nice strong core. You lift those elbows. We're going to go five more, four more, three more, two more, and one more. So we're going to grab the weights and continue to do that same movement. And again, you don't have to grab the weights if you don't want to. Making those nice strong shoulders. There's five more, four more, three more, two more, and one more. So let's drop the weight down. We're going to pull one up, and then we're going to drop that one down and pull the other one up and drop it down. Okay, so you're still at 45 degrees, and you're just pulling up one at a time. Okay, so it's like half of a row when we do our rows, okay, which we're going to do here in a little bit. We're going to do a full row, but this is like half of a row, just pulling up one at a time. Be really intentional as you draw the elbows up towards the sky and squeeze into your weights or your water bottles or whatever you have. And again, maybe you have nothing. Maybe you just make two fists as you do your row on each side. So here we go. Here's five more, four more, three more, two more, and last one. All right, so we're gonna do both. And if you wanna take a break and sit up, if you feel like you need a little break here, you can do that too. Just keep moving those arms. Okay, if you're here in that 45 degrees, just keep pulling those elbows up, drawing those weights up, or again, maybe no weights. Coming into a full row, breathing. Here we go. Let's go five more. Make them strong. Four more, three more, two more, and last one. All right. Nice job, you guys. Go ahead and set those weights aside. And just shake out those arms. Nice job. Breathe it up. Inhale. Flip those arms high, exhale, float it down. And one more time, big breath up, inhale. Exhale and float it down. So we're gonna work our core some more. We're gonna lean back this time. So lean back into your chair about 30 to 45 degrees. So it should look something like this. We're gonna take the right leg up. So you're holding onto your chair, holding onto something to brace you. Take the right leg up and then press out the heel. Bend the knee. Take it back down. So left leg up, press out that heel, bend the knee, take it back down. Right leg, press it out. Bend the knee, set it back down. Okay, so just keep alternating here. One leg at a time. Just take your time here. So you're working your core, you're working your legs. Now you will notice if you lift that leg higher, see how I'm lifting it higher here? That's going to be more work. So if you want more work, lift that leg higher as you press out. All right, so keep moving, keep breathing, pushing it out. Let's go five more. Notice that core, I can feel mine. You guys can too. Four more. Be intentional here with your movement. Make it strong. Three more. And two more. Way to go, you guys. It's our last one. Press it out. Good job. All right, go ahead and bring it back into center. Sit tall, lengthen that spine up towards the sky. Take a big breath in, reach up, exhale, float it down. And we'll do that one more time. Big breath up, inhale, exhale, float it down. All right, let's just go ahead and march it out here. Give that upper body a break. Let's use those legs and march. Nice job, and then let's go fast. Do your hot feet. Great job. We're gonna press palms up towards the sky. Hot feet, palms towards the sky. Press it up. Really press up the heels of the hands. Good job, you guys. There's five more. Four more. Three more. Two more. Last one. Let's drop it down. We'll go back to our march. Nice, easy march. Very nice. All right, we're going to do our hot feet one more time. Here we go. And you don't have to do it if you don't want to. If you want to just stay with the march, or if you want to move those feet really fast, it's up to you. And this time we're going to press in front. Bring it in, press in front. Hands are flexed. Just like before, press out. Press. Press. Press the palms and the heels, the hands out. Arms and legs moving. You guys are doing great. Keep that breath going. There's five more. Four more. Three more. Two more. And last one. All right, bring it back into center. We'll just march it out nice and easy. Oh, good job. Right. We'll take a few more marches here. And then we'll bring it back into center. Go ahead and stand on up. Come to the side of your chair. Come to the back of your chair. I'm going to turn mine to the side so you can see better. We're going to do our squat. So stand about arms distance away from your chair. Put my shoes back on. We're going to take your feet about hips distance apart, maybe a little wider. If that feels more stable for you, because we're doing squats, right? So you're going to sit it down and then take it up. So you want to get a little push forward on your hips. A lot of times people do squats and they don't come up all the way. Okay, that's not good for those hips. So you want to just maybe get that little stretch there, just push them forward a little bit. So lowering down, rising up, lowering down. Rising up. Really think about your glute muscles. This is really great work for your legs, but also your glute muscles. Okay, so just pressing down. So if you want to, if you feel stable enough and you want to take your hands off the chair and just make a fist, you're welcome to do that as well. Okay, you do not need to do that. You can keep those hands on the chair. And just do this at your pace. And you guys know I always count, but if you're doing something at a different pace and your counting isn't working with my counting, then that's okay. Okay? That's perfectly fine. See how low you can sit. The lower you sit, the better this is for your legs and glutes. Alright, so we're going to go five more. Again, your counting might be different. Four more. Three more. Two more, and one more. Good job, okay. All right, take a little stretch. So right foot forward, the left leg back. Stretching out that back leg and your hip flexors on the left side. Take a couple breaths here. And the front knee is bent, your back leg is straight, your back foot is turned out a little bit. That'll help protect your knee. All right, let's come on up and switch legs. Right leg comes back, left leg is forward. We'll do some more quad stretches too when we sit down and hip stretches. All right, so go ahead and take a couple more breaths here. Again, front knee bent, back leg straight, back foot is turned out about 45 degrees. There you go, you guys. Come on up. I'm going to do a little tree pose here for balance next to our chairs. So holding onto your chair, ground your foot and make that leg really strong. The one that's next to the chair, take your opposite foot to your leg. So you can take your toes and just leave them on the ground with your heel on your leg. Outside, hand on your waist. Or maybe you want to reach up in your full tree pose with your tree branches. Up to you. Okay, so make sure you're breathing here. You want to try to take that hand off the chair, that's up to you. Or another option is bring that foot up higher onto your leg so that your toes are not on the ground, but your foot is fully on your leg. But it's really up to you. Just play with it, see what you can do. And keep breathing and keep your eyes fixed on one spot. That's going to help. All right. Take another breath or two wherever you are. Just working on that balance of using that standing foot. Great job. Let's go to the other side of the chair. We'll do our tree on this side. So again, holding onto the chair, grounding the foot next to the chair and that leg. Keep it really straight and strong. Bring that other foot over. You can keep the toes on the ground and your heel on your standing leg. Okay, maybe that outside arm comes up through your tree branches. And the focal point, keep your eyes on one spot. So maybe you stay here, or maybe you take an option. Maybe you take your foot up onto your tree trunk. That standing leg. It's a really nice hip opener in your tree pose. You have a nice hip opener on that outside leg here. Maybe you take your hand off of the chair for a couple of seconds and drop it back down. Lots of options. Maybe keep your toes on the ground. Just make it work for you. You're working on your balance. So as long as you're challenging yourself and staying safe, you're doing great. Keep focusing, keep breathing. And have one more breath here. And then we'll drop it down. Go ahead and shake everything out. Nice job, you guys. Come back to your chair. Great job, everyone. And just take a few breaths. Let's float those arms up. And float the arms down with the exhale and do it again. Take a big breath up, inhale. Stretching up. Float your arms down with your exhale. All right, so let's stretch out our hips. So bringing your left foot or ankle to your right leg, making that triangle shape. And if that doesn't work, you can bring it to your lower leg. Okay, even maybe crossing at the ankle, that's fine too. Okay, wherever you are, we're gonna lean forward into it. You're looking down at the ground. Okay, the more that you lean into this, the more you're going to notice that stretch into your outside hip. So just think about where you're going with it. You can even use your hand to press into that leg if you want a little bit more. Just find what feels good for you. And we'll take a couple more breaths here. All right, great job, you guys. Come on up. Take that same leg all the way out. So we're gonna go for that nice lengthening. You might wanna come towards the edge of your chair, pulling your toes back on that left foot and then folding over. You can hold onto your chair or just lean into your legs. Draw the belly in and pull those toes back. Okay, we'll take a few breaths here. Pull the toes back as you send the heel out. All right, way to go. Let's come on up. So we'll do that other side. So right foot or ankle to your left leg. And again, down here is fine. Just make it work for you. Okay, wherever you can go with it. Leaning forward, looking down, drawing the belly in. Again, maybe you use your hands to press in. Maybe you feel a little deeper stretch into that right side. We'll take a few more breaths here. Sorry about the music, you guys. I've had the same little system for years, and some days it just doesn't feel like working, and then it's fine. It just is weird that way. All right, let's go ahead and come on up. So let's take that leg out, that right leg. Pull your toes back. Fold over when you're ready. Okay, keep pulling the toes back. Make sure you feel that stretch into the back of that right leg. Again, you're looking down, you're breathing. Couple more breaths here. Make it count, push that heel out. Go ahead and come on up. So we're gonna do our quad stretch. So you can come to the side of your chair to do it. I'm gonna come this way just to show you guys. So drop the knee down and walk your leg back. That's an option. That'll stretch out your quads. If you want to take your foot into your hand for your quad stretch, okay, that's another way to do it. Or grab your pants. Okay. We did those squats. So I wanted to make sure that we get these nice quad stretches in today. So take a few breaths here. And again, if you're just stretching it back this way, that works too. Great job, you guys. Way to go today. Thanks again for joining me. I appreciate you all. All right, let's come on up and we'll switch sides. So you can come to the side of your chair. Walk that leg back, or take the foot in your hand, dropping the knee down towards the ground. Again, grabbing your pants is an option. You can take the one you like. Make sure you're stable here. Make sure you're holding onto your chair. Core is strong, you're breathing. Job. We do all these stretches to avoid injuries. That's a bummer when you exercise and you get injured. So doing these stretches help us to avoid injury or just soreness or just achiness. Let's take a couple more breaths here. All right, go ahead. Release that. Come on back into center, sit nice and tall, and just roll out your shoulders. Maybe you close your eyes here. Making some nice big slow circles with your shoulders. Lots of nice shoulder work today. Just give those shoulders some love here. We'll take one more and we'll reverse. Again, no slouching. Make sure you're sitting tall. Good posture. And we'll take a couple more. All right, very nice. And then just looking over to the left, looking over to the right, and to the left, and to the right. One more left, one more right. Bring your head to center, gently look down, pressing your chin towards your chest. Just stay here, take your hands and gently press into the back of your head. So just a very gentle pressure here. You're looking down, pressing chin towards chest. We'll take two or three breaths here. And then release that. Bring your chin up and look up towards the sky, dropping your shoulders down, just stretching out your throat. And we'll take two or three breaths here. Very nice. Come back into center. So sitting tall, big breath all the way up, stretching up. Exhale, float the arms down, and then we're going to do one more big breath up. We're going to take that big forward fold as we exhale, bringing your body to your legs, dropping your head down, and just stay here for three or four breaths as you let the crown of your head reach towards the ground, making sure to look back behind you. Last breath. So now slowly draw your body up with that rounded spine. You're going to come all the way up. Just draw the hands up and then bring your back to your chair. Your back comes to the back of your chair. Your arms float to the side, letting your fingertips reach to the ground. Just let those fingertips and fingers and hands become really heavy. With your eyes closed. And then noticing your entire arms becoming very heavy all the way up to your shoulders. Feel your shoulders sinking down. And then feeling your chest and your belly, feeling your breath moving through, just allowing your body to relax. Give yourself permission to allow the body to soften as you let your hips, your glute muscles, and your lower back become relaxed. Letting your back relax, feeling where your back meets the chair. And just allow the back to fully relax. And then bring your attention down to your feet. Notice the soles of your feet, where they meet the ground. Notice your toes, notice the tops of your feet. And just let your feet relax. Letting your heels and your ankles also relax. All the way up to your knees. And just letting your lower legs relax. Calf muscles, shins. And then letting your upper legs relax. Again, just giving yourself permission to let go of those muscles. Feeling your quadriceps that you stretched and strengthened today. Just feel them just melt and relax. Feeling your hamstrings also relaxing. And then just notice the softness in your feet and your legs. Just the heaviness in your hands and your arms all the way up to those shoulders. And then bring your attention to your neck and just relax your neck. Relax your jaw. Let it drop down a little, allowing your tongue and your mouth to release and let go. Into your facial muscles, your cheeks, your forehead. Think about the muscles between your eyes also Relax all those muscles. All the way to the top of the head, down the back of your head. Just truly releasing. Feeling the heaviness of your head. And the softness of your breath. So again, John 15, 1 through 3 says, I am the true vine, and my Father is the gardener. He cuts off every branch in me that bears no fruit, while every branch that does bear fruit, he prunes, so that it will be even more fruitful. You are already clean because of this word I have spoken. So just thinking about cutting back, maybe it's just one thing you need to get rid of that encumbers you, that weighs you down or drags you down. And again, this can be physical, this can be relationships, this can be a financial matter. We have lots of things that are dead weight that need to be cleared out, need to be simplified. Let's take a moment here just to breathe and rest and reflect on God's good word in John 15, 1 through 3 and what that means to you, where you might need to cut back. Wonderful job, ladies. Let's bow our heads in prayer so you can sit tall or stay right where you are. Dearest Heavenly Father God, we're so thankful for this time together to stretch and strengthen our bodies and just to think about how we need to cut these things back in our lives. God, show us where we need to cut back. Show us where we need to prune so that we can be the people you want us to be. More effective for your kingdom. Thank you, Lord, for these beautiful women. I pray this time together has blessed them from the inside out and from top to bottom, and that you have nourished them, mind, body, and soul. Lord, we just thank you for what you did for us on the cross. We're so thankful for our salvation. We can never, ever thank you enough. We give you all the glory and all the honor and all the praise. In your holy and precious name that we pray. Amen and amen. Beautiful job, everybody. Way to go. Thank you so much for joining me today.